Hey guys, what's going on? Dakota Harp here with Harp Films. I have a lot of stuff that I carry around day to day, and I have different bags that I use for different purposes, but one that I've really enjoyed, that I've really loved, I've had it for about a year, a little bit under a year now, and I wanted to tell you all about it today, is the Boundary Supply Errant Pack. So this is the bag right here, and like I said, I've had it for almost a year now, and I love it for several different reasons that I'm gonna get into, but I wanna tell you how I found this bag. So last year we took a trip to New Zealand and I had this Herschel backpack that was supposed to be water resistant, all this different stuff. Well, we went on this water excursion. So long story short, I had my MacBook, my camera in there, and I got about an inch of water in the bottom of it. So luckily my camera was fine, but my MacBook now has a jacked up headphone port. Some of the USB ports don't work. So after that, I decided that one, I needed a pack that was going to store all the gear that I had, just for an average day of shooting or maybe a quick trip or something like that. But I also needed something that was going to be durable, weather resistant, and kind of convenient. So I sat down and made a list of everything I wanted in a bag. I wanted something that was going to be durable in weather, that would preferably have some kind of water resistance to it, that would be fine in rain and possibly even setting it down in just a little bit of water. At this time, I was also starting to do more trips, more traveling shoots and things like that, so I needed something that was going to work well on a plane. I wanted something that was gonna have plenty of organizable storage. Maybe that was even modular, where I could add in things or take away things to suit my different types of shoots and different types of traveling needs. I wanted something that was also gonna be TSA friendly, something that whenever I get there, I can just unzip it, whip my laptop out, put it back in, be done. Not have to worry about, you know, this Herschel bag. It wasn't really designed for a 15-inch MacBook Pro, so I kinda have to peel it back and then wedge it out and then set it down, and then getting it back in was a headache. Zippers weren't super good or durable. So I looked at Lopro, I looked at Pelican, North Face, I looked at Patagonia, I looked at hiking backpacks, I looked at photography backpacks, I looked at all these different kinds of backpacks, shoulder bags, sling packs, everything, and I couldn't find anything that I liked. I take that back. I found one bag that I liked. So the only other bag that really caught my attention was the Lopro Dry Zone, I think is it's called, and it still did not even meet all the criteria that I was looking at. I wanted something that looked cool, that had a lot of storage, that was organizable, that was potentially modular and waterproof, and the only thing it really had going for it was that it was waterproof. It was kind of small, and it only came in yellow, which is not a good color for me. Still a great pack, but not what I'm looking for. And so I said, you know what? I'm gonna wait until I can find a bag that meets all these criteria, because if I'm gonna spend some money on it, I wanna make sure that I'm gonna get everything. So I'm on Instagram one day, checking my story, and I get an ad for this company called Boundary Supply, and they advertise this bag called the Errant Pack. So the price on this bag is $199, $200 even. Which is, in my personal opinion, that's a phenomenal price for what you're getting. I've seen $200 on a lot of other camera bags, and it's great because they have the padded dividers and things like that, but honestly, $200 for what I got with this, especially when you compare it to something like the Dry Zone, that's $395, you know, you're saving a whole $200 off of the total price, which I think is awesome. So let's talk about this pack a little. So right here, we have the front flap, and these are magnetic, which I think is... It was kind of weird to figure out at first, but once you figure it out, they just clip in place, you know, and it does not come undone, and then you just pull it off. It's super secure, but it's also got this zipper under here. Now, they tell you that this zipper here is not waterproof, but that's why they have the front flap on it, so you can still protect all your goods and things inside of there. It's a little bit weird to zip, as you can see, but once you get it going, it goes all the way around. Super easy to get at your stuff inside. Right here, and then as well right here, they have these little attachments where you can clamp in all kinds of little accessories. You can put your keys right here. Really cool modular stuff that you can get, like the camera pack and stuff like that. Right here you also have, I use this for sunglasses. It's nice and soft, it's felt on the inside. Sometimes I'll use it for SD cards. It just depends on really what I'm going to do that day. You also have this little hook right here, and I think you've got some more down here at the bottom. And that's pretty much it as far as the front of the pack goes. Now, we'll flip it around, and this is like my favorite part of the whole thing. So if you look at the top of this bag right here, you can kind of see it on the video. It's got this awesome weather-sealed zipper. that works super well. I have tested it. I've worn this in the rain. We get a lot of really heavy rain down here in Louisiana, so it works really well. I've never had any water at all in this pack. So if we open it up, you can see it's super easy. It opens all the way down, which is perfect, like I was saying, for like TSA or whatever, and it folds all the way out. So if we look right here, this is a 2012 15-inch MacBook Pro, and it fits perfectly in here. I mean, this compartment's huge, but it doesn't feel like it. This doesn't feel like a big, bulky backpack. It really fits well. It's symmetrical. It just looks good. You've got, and this is another one of those magnetic clips I was talking about. So it just clips right back on. This thing is, I play with this all the time because it's so secure. I mean, it's not coming undone, but then it's like butter. But you can also unclip it further, and I keep a notebook in here for notes and script ideas and all kinds of stuff like that. You got some mesh pockets. I've got some little notes here and a hard drive and a USB-C cable. We turn it around. I've got books and more hard drives and all kinds of miscellaneous stuff in here. You have another mesh pocket on the side. This is a remote for one of the lights I use. And I don't think I have anything in here. Got some keys in this other mesh pocket. And then this one up here, I keep a little carabiner on it. Just, you never know when you need a carabiner. And if you unzip it, I keep camera batteries in here today, but sometimes it's SD cards, sometimes it's chargers, sometimes it's headphones. It really just depends on what I'm doing. That's it for the main compartment of the bag, so we'll go ahead and zip that up. But it does bring me to my only downside on this bag, and it really just broke my heart, literally and figuratively. So right here, you can see it right there. This zipper just straight up broke one day. So I was just using the bag one day and the zipper just straight up broke. Like, here, I kept it. That is what happened to the zipper. Just plain and simple, broke. I do have to say though that the Boundary Supply customer service was super awesome. And they wound up sending me a replacement. It wasn't the replacement I wanted. They didn't send the exact same metal zipper. They sent this little kind of a paracord tie. So that's kind of a bummer that they're not gonna match now, but I do have to pry open the zipper, put it on there and everything. But at least they were kind enough to send me something. I can think of a lot of people's customer service who could really use some interaction like that. So shout out to you, Boundary Supply. You guys are awesome. Last few features on here, we have a water bottle holder. You can also use it to hold a tripod because you have another one of these fancy clips on the front. But this one is not magnetic, but it is much more heavy duty. But it just clips around to the front right here, like so. We also have another magnetic clasp here on the side. This prevents the bag from just flying open if you unzip it, but it's also really easy to undo, like if you're going through TSA or for some reason you need to lay your bag out flat. Then on these handles right here, we have all kinds of little loops right here. That is so you can get more of these. Let me see if I can pull this off. So you can get extra little buckles and they slide in and out pretty easy, but for me that's kind of the problem with them. So it's a little, like this one for right here is another magnetic clasp, clips together, but I find that these little loops kind of pop out a lot. It may just be me, maybe I'm just really rough on bags, but in my personal opinion, they don't work super great, just because I think they're designed to be really easy to put in and out, and because of that, that's kind of their biggest weakness. Have a little buckle for if you go hiking, or if you are doing some extra activity and you need to make sure that it stays secure and you don't want to hurt yourself. Last couple of things right here, we do have a side handle, which I thought was going to be really awesome going through maybe an airport or something like that where I could just take it off my back if I wanted to give my back a break, or maybe even attach it to a suitcase. In all actuality, it's not very good. So if I stand up like this, you can kind of see that it angles in towards the side. I would much rather have seen maybe another handle on this side so that it would hang straight down. But because of that, you kind of have to hold it out from your body and it's just uncomfortable on the shoulders. It's not super good, but it's nice to have it. Good thought. So right next to that handle though, we have this beauty right here. Ooh, It's like reinforced and everything. So you can store something really, this is where I store like my passport whenever I go through the airport. You can even put your wallet in here, cash, and you don't have to worry about anybody robbing you if you're in an area that you have to deal with pickpockets. You don't have to worry about anybody sneaking in there because it's right against your back and you can't really even see it whenever you wear it, which is really nice. And it's a really heavy duty pocket. I absolutely love it. And of course, we have a little side pocket here. This is normally where I keep pens, pencils, but I don't really have any. Oh, wait, got one pen. But really what I use this for most of the time is it's got a little port right here. And I saw them do this in one of their ads. I will normally keep my solar powered power bank in here after I charge it, and I will run the cable through here, and I can charge batteries in my pack while I'm traveling off of that. I can charge my phone. There's all kinds of cool stuff that you can do with a feature like that. So very handy, and a very easily placed zipper that you can actually undo while you're wearing the pack very easily. And as I said before, down here at the bottom, we have the wet dry compartment, which right now has my socks in there from earlier that I need to bring home. And that's it. That's the Errant Pack by Boundary Supply. Even knowing about the drawbacks, the broken zipper, and the inconveniently placed handle, those are very, very minor things. It's still a very comfortable pack. It's a very functional pack, and it's weather resistant, and it just looks cool. This thing comes in navy, black, and tan. I think maybe they call it camel or something like that, or maybe it's just tan. I don't know. I went with navy because my last Herschel bag was navy. I like navy. It works with a lot of different things. After having it for a little while, I might have gone with maybe tan because this material in the front does show scratches really well. You can't really see it in the video, but if you look closely, it's got a lot of scuffs everywhere. I still love it though. It's got character. It's a little beaten up after having it for this long. So I'll put the link below. Make sure you go and check out Boundary Supply and their multitude of packs, but especially the Errant Pack, my favorite. And I'm always looking for new recommendations on bags that I want to check out, that I want to try. So if you have a recommendation for me, make sure you comment it below so I can go check them out for myself. That's it. That's all I got for you. So until next time.